Hello students, welcome to Ishwari Tanisha channel. Today in this video we are going to discuss about hyperconjugation. So students, this topic comes under general organic chemistry. So general organic chemistry, you can see this topic. So that is inductive effect, hyperconjugation, all these things. So this is mainly for NEET and JEE students. So let us discuss the topic here. So what is hyperconjugation? So hyperconjugation is also known as no bond resonance. No bond resonance. Okay, and it involves, so if hyperconjugation has to take place, sp2 carbon and sp3 carbon should be attached to each other. That is, sp2 carbon should be attached to sp3 carbon, and this sp3 carbon should have hydrogen atom with it. So this sp3 carbon should contain hydrogen atom, contain hydrogen atom. So this is the main basic which is required for hyperconjugation to take place. So sp2 carbon should be attached to sp3 carbon, and it should be having hydrogen atom. So let us take the example and see how hyperconjugation takes place. So example, okay, so this we call it as allylic carbon atoms. So that is, there is a double bond and there is single bond, alternating double and single bond. So here, to check for the hyperconjugation to take place, so you should see whether sp2 carbon is attached to sp3 carbon. So students, here this carbon is sp2 carbon and this will be sp3 carbon, and to this sp3 carbon you can see 3 hydrogen atoms are attached. So to the sp3 carbon atom you should see hydrogen atom is present or not. So here to sp3 carbon 3 hydrogen atoms are present, therefore you can say that this molecule will undergo hyperconjugation. So now how this will undergo hyperconjugation, let us check. So now what happens is, this bond, so this bond we call it as sigma bond. So this is sigma bond and this will be pi bond. So now sigma bond will shift here and this pi bond will shift here. So as a result you will be getting double bond here, single bond here, and then this electron has shifted to this carbon, so you will get negative sign over here, and then the hydrogen atom which has given away the electron, so it will be present here as H+. So this will be present close to the molecule, H+ ion will be present close to the molecule. So you can see here there is no bond between hydrogen and carbon, but still it stays close to the molecule because of the attraction. So that is why it is called as no bond resonance. Even though there is no bond, hydrogen ion stays close to that of the carbon atom. So now this is one resonating structure. So another structure, if I want to write, so for one hydrogen atom I have written the hyperconjugation structure. So same way we can write for this carbon atom. So I can write here H+, and then here carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, double bond, CH, CH2-. So for second carbon, second hydrogen we have written. So same way we can write for the third hydrogen atom as well. So now I can write this as hydrogen, carbon, hydrogen, and here H+. So now there is a double bond here, CH, CH2, and then there is negative sign. So now these are the hyperconjugation structures. Okay, so 3 hydrogen atoms, so we have written here 3 hyperconjugation structures for this. So now this hydrogen atoms, that is the hydrogen atoms which are attached to this carbon, we call it as alpha hydrogen atoms. So this are called as alpha hydrogen atoms. So now check here how many alpha hydrogen atoms are there. So in this molecule totally you can see to this carbon 3 hydrogen atoms are present, which is alpha hydrogen atom. So in this molecule you can say there are 3 alpha hydrogen atoms. So these are the hyperconjugation structures of this molecule. So now let us see the stability of any hyperconjugating structures. So let us compare which is more stable. Suppose a question is given to you. So question. So here CH3, C double bond C, CH3, then here CH3. So this is one molecule you are comparing with C double bond C, CH3, hydrogen here and then hydrogen here. So if these two molecules are given for comparison and you want to find out which is more stable in this. Okay students, first molecule let us check out. So here first you know that if CH3 group is attached, it shows positive inductive effect. So this shows positive inductive effect, even this shows, even this. So all the four groups shows positive inductive effect. Whereas here, two groups shows positive inductive effect. So coming to hyperconjugation, check how many alpha hydrogen atoms are present here. So here this is sp2 carbon. So this will be sp3 carbon. Same way this will be sp3 carbon. And here this is sp2, so this will be sp3 carbon and this will be sp3 carbon. So how many alpha hydrogen atoms are present to sp3 carbon? 3 plus 3 6, 6 plus 3 9, 9 plus 3 12. So there are 12. So there are 12 alpha hydrogen atoms attached. And in this case here this is sp2 and this will be sp3 and even this is sp3. So here you can see total 3 plus 3 is 6. So 6 alpha hydrogen atoms are present. So students, remember here, more the number of alpha hydrogen atom, more will be the stability. So when you compare these two molecules, the more stable molecule will be this. So whenever stability if you want to compare, see which is having more alpha hydrogen atoms, so that molecule will be more stable. So this is about hyperconjugation. So in further videos I'll take some more examples to compare the stability between the molecules using hyperconjugation. So I'll meet you in the next video, students. Bye bye.